With us now for more is Dr. Mary Jean Loreche, spokesperson and chief pathologist of DOH Region 7. Good afternoon, doctor, and thank you so much for taking our call.
Good afternoon, po.
Dr. Loreche, earlier in the press briefing, Environment Secretary Royce Matu have said that there have been lapses in the implementations of restrictions between the Cebu City government and the LGUs. May I get your thoughts on this, please?
Basically, po, kasi remember that the implementation already, even for the different public health measures that we have, that the Department of Health has been espousing and has been telling our people, in the implementation, it has to be the local government units that has to do the implementation itself. Mm-hmm. And so apparently, there is some lag in these two different ways of handling this problem here in Visayas. But I would say that if you, I heard the report a while ago, but if you will also notice that the first area that did a zero prevalence testing for surveillance was actually and is actually the province of, Visayas, no? Mm-hmm. So gumawa po kami ng community testing, more than 40,000 individuals were tested. And we were able to get the zero prevalence for those that are IgM positives. And the positivity now of Cebu City is actually a reflection of that seroprevalence test that we did. Mm-hmm. So I believe that the city government for Cebu City alone and for the other surrounding areas, the three cities, the LGUs are also doing their very best to be able to help in the containment of the problem. But if you also, let's also face the fact that the community transmission is already very high. Mm-hmm. And there is already exposure. At alam naman po natin na itong COVID ay mabilis talaga pong kumalat. Mm-hmm. No? So I think that's one of the things that we have to consider. Mm-hmm. Of the 100%, for example, 100% of our individuals who may be exposed to it, 80% of those who are positive are asymptomatic. And so this data alone, having an 80%, reflective of asymptomatics, that if you look at the data, those who are positive, you will be able to disaggregate the data telling us that not everybody who are PCR positives are actually symptomatic. Mm-hmm. Some 80% of that are asymptomatic, meaning to say that is a clear indication that we are talking about community transmission already.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Doctor, you're saying that the LGs are trying their best to curb the pandemic, but they're with Cebu now going on stricter restrictions, going back to ECQ, and the quarantine fatigue of people is already high. What do you think are other problems that we have to address, especially now that the numbers are rising and just rising?
Basically, heto po talaga kung sinasabi. At the end of the day, it's not about the LGU, it's not about the department. Mm-hmm. It's about us, the Filipinos. It's mm-hmm. us. Bawat isa po sa atin may dapat gampanan, no, na role. Dapat po lahat tayo ay makibaka against COVID. Kapag, even if we put in the strictest measures and controls to be able to curb the movement of people in order for us to curb also the transmission, not the transmission rate. If tayo din, individuals, as community members, hindi naman din natin gagawin and dapat natin gawin, what more should we be expecting? Mm-hmm. Kasi ang ating gobyerno po, the LGU, the Department of Health, they're doing their parts. Ginagawa po nila yan. Pero heto po ngayon ang katanungan po, hindi ka naman dapat lumabas ng bahay. Bakit ka lalabas ng bahay? Mm-hmm. Alam mo naman na dapat pag nasa labas ka at nakipagsalamuha ka sa mga tao, you should be wearing your mask. Bakit mm-hmm. hindi mo gawin yun? O mali yung paggamit mo ng iyong mask. O kaya naman, itong paghugas ng kamay, very simple, very basic. And yet, kailangan pa po ba talaga na i-implement yan ng ating mga LGUs at ng mm-hmm. ating mga government agencies. Hindi po ba bawat isa sa atin, that is our responsibility, na tulungan natin ang bawat isa. Hindi po kakayanin po, kahit na maglagay tayo ng ilan pang tangking budigera dyan, kahit maglagay tayo ng marami pang sack, no, to mm-hmm. be able to implement this. If it doesn't come from deep within us, our responsibility for ourselves, for our families, for our community, for our country, paliwala po yan.
Mm-hmm. So it's like reflective of what the president has said, that Cebuanos have quite hard-headed when it comes to following orders. Would you agree with that?
Hindi naman po matitigas ang ulo po ng mga Cebuano.
Mm-hmm.
Kundi medyo complacent lang talaga. Mm-hmm. Siguro alam niyo naman po na tayo individually by human nature, we feel we are in, you know, invincible. So sometimes nandun po yan eh. And I don't think that's really, you know, a character trait for the Cebuanos. Mm-hmm. But every Filipinos, I think that we get to see, sila po yung, lahat po tayo niyan has that kind of attitude.
Mm-hmm.
And there has to be a paradigm shift for us to be able to combat this disease.
Mm-hmm. All right. Doctor, looking at the numbers now, hospitals in Cebu City are not really operating at full capacity, but at over capacity, especially on the critical care facilities, the number of beds available for COVID cases, also for other diseases, and especially on equipment that they use. How will the DOH augment the needs in both government and private hospitals? What are your plans on this?
Basically po, the Department of Health has already helped our private hospitals.
Mm-hmm.
No? Wala naman po problema sa mga government hospitals natin kasi nandyan naman po talaga ang Department of Health.
Mm-hmm.
But for the private hospitals, we have already augmented their manpower by deploying nurses to them to help them increase their beds. No, that will be allocated to COVID.
Mm-hmm.
We are also providing them with the necessary PPEs. Binigay po namin yan lahat sa kanila. At ang pangatlo nga po ngayon, ito po yung gusto nila na ma-augment din yung kanilang medical frontliners by giving them, you know, yung mga graduates na mga, you know, who has finished their postgraduate internship 2 years ago prior to COVID. May mga request po kami natatanggap na bigyan sila ng augmentation for that medical front lines. And we are also preparing for that. So pag sinabi po ninyong augmentation, ano ang ginagawa ng Department of Health, ginagawa po namin kung ano po pwede namin gawin upang matulungan po ang ating mga pribadong paggamutan.
Mm-hmm. But doctor, there are also reports saying that some medical personnel are wanting to quit in fear of their safety, their health safety and their lives. Some hospitals are also not everybody is accepting COVID cases. What do you think about this?
As a medical doctor, speaking for myself, I cannot speak for everybody, okay? Although everybody, all of us who are medical doctors, whether you're a general practitioner or a specialist, meron po tayong pinanumpaan. We have what we call the Hippocratic Oath, wherein we are supposed to be giving our lives, everything that we have, in the service of our patients.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, because the fear is, it's not just about themselves. I cannot blame the medical professionals for wanting to quit because they also have to think about their families.
Mm-hmm.
Every time you are placed there in a COVID ward, taking care of seriously ill or critically ill patients, your fear is when you reach home, when you arrive home, would you be able to protect your families and loved ones from you bringing the virus itself? So ang akin pong panawagan sa mga kapwa po na mga espesyalista at mga doktor, kahit pa paano po, para kung gyera ito, hindi po natin pwedeng piliin ang ating kaaway. Ang pwede po natin magsilbi pa rin po sa ating mga pasyente kahit po tayo natatakot. Ngunit kailangan, we have to put in and implement all the necessary infection control measures so that we will be able to protect ourselves by wearing the proper PPEs. And when we arrive home or before tayo umuwi, dapat po tayo ay nagligo na din, naghugas, nakalagay pa rin yung ating mga mask na panibago upang pagdating natin sa ating mga pamamahay ay hindi po natin madala yung sakit sa ating mga pamilya.
Mm-hmm. All right. Lastly, before I let you go, Dr. Loreche, there have also been problems on mortuary facilities for the deceased, not just on COVID patients. How is this going to be addressed?
We have an ongoing discussion. The Department of Health has already, you know, has ongoing discussions with the owners of the funeral parlors. Kasi nga po, ang takot nga po ng mga tao ngayon ay kapag na-COVID, ay baka mamaya, kahit napatay na ito, ay baka mamaya mahawa po sila. I think proper education, proper interpretation of what's going on around us, And the knowledge that we are able to give and impart to the mortuaries, to the people, no? I think that will go a very long way by educating them on how to properly dispose of the dead bodies. And, you know, reminding them na hindi naman po talaga natin nakukuha ang COVID kung sakaling patay na yan ay dumating sa atin, unless na yung kanilang mga secretions ay meron na, no? But then, based on our studies, at alam naman po natin, sinabi niya ng WHO at mga Centers for Disease Control, na heto po COVID, nakukuha naman po to aerosol droplet. So kung meron po mga secretions na alam natin na posible na magiging dahilan upang makahawa po yung skin na ito, if we put again the necessary infection control measures, heto naman po ay pwede naman po natin maiwasan din.
All right, everything you've said, Dr. Loreche, has been duly noted. Thank you so much for your time, Doctor, and do take care.
Thank you po. Maraming salamat.